Hello and welcome to this video tutorial. Gareth here from tastytutes.com. In this tutorial, I'm going to discuss backwards compatibility in Adobe InDesign and demonstrate how we can create IDML files. So what's this all about? Well, over the past few years, InDesign has been bringing out various versions of its software. Currently, I'm using Adobe InDesign CC 2014. Now, if I save an InDesign file using my current updated version of InDesign and send it to someone who uses InDesign, say CS5 or earlier, then they will not be able to open the document. The file will not be compatible. So to allow someone to open our document using a different version of InDesign, we will need to export an IDML file. So let's take a look at how this can be done. So here I am in InDesign, and here I have the brochure document open we created earlier in the course. If you have been following along with this course, be sure to open your brochure document. Though if you're new to this course and wish to follow along, you can get access to the InDesign file in the project folder. Link is in the description. Remember, you will also have to install the fonts when you open the document. That can also be found in the project folder. So with the document open, come up to File, scroll down and click Export. Upon click, up will pop a window asking you where you want to save. Now, if we pay close attention to the bottom of this window, we can see we have a format option. Currently, this is set to Adobe PDF. Now, if I click this, we can choose InDesign Markup IDML. So I'll be sure to choose this. Now, you can save this anywhere, but I'll save this into my project folder, into the compatibility folder. So I'll keep the file name the same and click Save. Once saved, I'll press Command W to close the document. So I'll open up my project folder and navigate to my compatibility folder. And here we can see the file. Now, if we look closely, we can see that the icon for this document is different from the usual InDesign document icon. This is indicating it's an InDesign Markup IDML file. Now, should I send this to someone with a different version of InDesign, they should be able to open it just fine. So that's how you can export an IDML file in Adobe InDesign for backwards compatibility. Now, sending an IDML file is one thing. This will enable someone else to open the file. But the problem with simply sending the IDML file is that whoever opens the file may not have the correct fonts installed, will not be able to access or edit images inside the file, and they will not be able to export a print-ready PDF. So why is that? Well, that is because all the links that are contained within the document reside on my computer. If I want someone else to be able to open the document, access the links inside and export a print-ready PDF, I'm going to have to package the document. In the next and final episode of this course, I will be discussing and demonstrating how to package a document in InDesign. See you in the next video.